the language we all understand.
Good evening and welcome. My name is Matthew Doyle. I'm a descendant of the Murawari Aboriginal Nation from the far northwest of New South Wales. However, I was born here in Sydney on Gadigal land. And we are coming to you today from the land of the Cammeraygal. Cammeraygal are one of the many clans that make up the Eora and the Darug nations here in Sydney. It is customary in our culture that we acknowledge country. We also acknowledge our ancestors, the spirits of this land, and of course, our elders, the storytellers and the knowledge holders. I'd like to welcome you here onto Cammeraygal land. Dajibalang Onia Yoli Birong Gumaragu Ngurang Cammeraygal Ora Ungungamania Talinarangun Panyajiminka Chalkalania. That's acknowledging country, ancestors and spirits. And we welcome you here with open arms and embrace you. And we ask that you respect the country that you are on as well. I'd like to welcome you with a song. Thank you.
Panya jaminka caklania, hey. Hello and welcome to the 2021 Australian Export Awards. Now in its 59th year, I'm David Kosh, and on behalf of the Australian Trade and Investment Commission and the Australian Chamber of Commerce and Industry, a very warm welcome to all. It is great to have so many of you joining us from all across Australia. And what a wonderful start to proceedings tonight with Matthew Doyle delivering just such a moving welcome to country. In fact, we'd love to know which First Nations country you're joining us from, so tell us on the app. And if you haven't downloaded the official app, Eventcast by Fourth Wall, you can download it using the QR code on your screen now. Once downloaded, open the app, then enter the event code Export Awards. Select Login and enter your email address and unique PIN, which was sent to you via email. Can't find your PIN? Hey, no problem, we got you covered. Click Reset Passport Password / Get PIN at the bottom of the login page and look out for a password reset email in your inbox. Use the chat icon to share your congratulations to the finalists and winners throughout the ceremony. We'd love to hear from you. And for now, let us know which First Nations country you're viewing from. We are here to celebrate the key successes across Australia's exporting industries, an opportunity for the Australian government to recognise and applaud your achievements. The Australian Export Awards celebrates the entrepreneurs that call Australia home. We're honoured to have with us representatives from 89 winning companies from the 8 state and territory export award programs. These Australian businesses have achieved international export excellence and in turn contributed to Australia's economic prosperity. We're announcing the winners in each of the 13 national categories, from Emerging Exporter of the Year to Advanced Technologies. These winners will join a cohort of incredible exporters that since 1963 have outshone all others. And of course, we'll be announcing the big one, the 2021 Australian Exporter of the Year. Can't wait for that. We're thrilled to have a live performance to set the tone for tonight's celebrations. I'd like to welcome Strings Source Quintet. Fantastic. Give them a round of applause wherever you are watching. Isn't it wonderful? Bit of class from the Strings. And of course, our creative arts and music sector is a very big exporter as well. So great to have Strings Source with us tonight. And we will hear from them throughout the show. Now, we asked you earlier to share which First Nations country you're watching from on the app. So let's take a look at some of those comments that have come through. Thank you for sending them through. Nicolina is in Wiradjuri country. Romina is in Darawal country. Carly joining from Cammeraygal land, close by. And Sarah acknowledges the traditional custodians of the Eastern Kulin Nation, where she is viewing from. And we'll be reading your comments from the app throughout the show. So keep them coming. And don't forget to share the celebration across all your social media with the hashtag Export Awards. It's now my pleasure to introduce Australia's Minister for Trade, Tourism and Investment, the Honourable Dan Tehan.
Thanks, Koshy, and it's great to be with you. And can I also acknowledge that wonderful welcome to country from Matthew? And it took me back only a week ago when I was opening the Grampians Peak Trail, where three of our Indigenous groups came together because that trail goes across three of their lands. And we had a wonderful smoking ceremony, didgeridoo playing, and this currawong just started singing along to the didgeridoo out of the bush. It was incredibly special moment and highlighted how much our Indigenous ancestry is going to play not only in our tourism services exports, but I think more and more in our traditional exports as well. Can I welcome everyone here tonight for what is a terrific award ceremony? We're going to showcase the very best of our exporters. And the incredible thing about tonight is that we're showcasing the very best of our exporters having come through a pandemic, a once in a century pandemic. And yet the resilience that our exporters have shown, their ability to continue to do what they do best, earn income and provide jobs for our community, has shone through. And our export performance throughout this pandemic has been quite extraordinary. As a matter of fact, when we look back over the last 18 months, 2 years, what our exporters have achieved, I think deserves a gold medal for everyone, and in particular, a gold medal for everyone who has been nominated tonight. So I'm really looking forward to tonight's award ceremony. I'm looking forward to the deserved recognition that every exporter will get. Thank you, everyone who's been involved. What you're achieving for our nation is quite extraordinary. One in five jobs are dependent on exports right across our nation. It's one in four in regional and rural Australia. And our economic performance through this pandemic, the success of it, is in no small part to what our exporters have done for the last 2 years. So I commend you, I congratulate you, and it's wonderful to see that you will be recognised for what you have done through a once-in-a-century pandemic, how you have made sure that our nation has been able to deal what's been thrown at us and come out of it at the other end, I think, even stronger than when we went into it. So, Koshy, great to be with you tonight. Back to you, and I look forward to seeing you when I announce the Australian Exporter of the Year at the end of tonight's program.
Yep. Minister, can't wait as well. And as you say, the hurdles our exporters have had to get over this year is remarkable. So, amazing achievement for everyone. Catch you later in the program. I'd now like to introduce the Australian Trade and Investment Commission, Chief Executive Officer, Xavier Simonet.
I'm excited to be joining you today for my first Australian Export Awards as CEO of the Australian Trade and Investment Commission. Now, in its 59th year, this is one of the longest running business award programs in Australia. Our finalists tonight have incredible stories of achievement, from designing life-saving heart pumps to producing award-winning documentaries. These businesses are taking Australian innovation onto the world stage and in some cases into space. Our 89 finalists together employed more than 17,000 people last financial year and generated more than $6.2 billion in export earnings. A third of them are small businesses, demonstrating you don't need to be a big player to make a major contribution. Of course, these awards would not be possible without our state and territory program partners. Thank you for your commitment and involvement. I would also like to acknowledge the generosity of our sponsors tonight, who are all champions of business success. and offer our thanks for the invaluable contribution of all our judges who share their time and expertise. A special thank you to our national judging panel, Andrew McKellar, Chief Executive Officer of the Australian Chamber of Commerce and Industry. Swati Dave, Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer of Export Finance Australia. Ben Lazara, Chief Executive Officer, Australian Made Campaign. And Michael Loutram, APM, Commissioner, Australian Border Force. Austrade is incredibly proud to run this award program to recognise and applaud the stellar achievements of our Australian exporting businesses. We hope you have found the experience uplifting. I look forward to continuing to work with you all into the future. If you ever need a helping hand in your export endeavours, Austrade is here to help you go further and faster. Good luck.
Good on you, Xavier. Thank you for that. Now, the calibre of finalists this year has been absolutely amazing, and it's no easy feat to make the list. From a field of 287 applicants at both state and territory and national level, we've curated a list of finalists, all of whom were winners within their state and territory programs. We thank you for all of your efforts and commitment to these awards. All right, let's get stuck into it. Our first category is Advanced Technologies for Outstanding International Success in the Field of Information Technology, Digital Technologies, Software, Hardware or Digital Services, including solutions utilising cloud-based platforms, Artificial Intelligence, Machine Learning, Internet of Things, Augmented or Virtual Reality and Blockchain. This award is sponsored by Singularity U Australia, and here to join me in presenting co-chief executive officers Lisa Andrews and Christina Gerakaitis. Lisa and Christina, over to you to tell us a bit about why Singularity U Australia supports the Export Awards, and don't forget to announce the finalists.
Thanks, Koshi. We know that Australians have had a disproportionate impact through innovation and exports for many years. Our focus is on using technology to scale internationally. We want to tenfold that impact.
When we speak at various conferences globally, our international colleagues are actually in awe of the impact we as Australians are having. So supporting the Austrade Business Awards is a way of increasing our international presence. So the finalists for the Advanced Technologies category are AVI, Western Australia, Drone Shield, New South Wales, Fivecast, South Australia, Intercluster, Australian Capital Territory, Lightning Protection International, Tasmania, OMC International, Victoria, Shorthand, Queensland, and SPEED3D, Northern Territory.
Congratulations to all of the finalists.
And the winner of the Australian Export Award for Advanced Technologies is Drone Shield. Congratulations to Drone Shield. Drone Shield was established in 2014 and has become a global market leader in counter-drone protection in under 10 years. Customers in 120 countries. And Lyle, congratulations. Are you able to appreciate just how big an impact you're having?
Oh, thank you very much for the award. I mean, yeah, the company has grown a huge amount and changed a huge amount in the last 12 months. As you say, we've been exporting all around the world. Our growth in America, Europe and APAC has been considerable over the last 12 months, and very proud to be part of the company. And we're proud to be a company that's promoting public safety in these increasingly uncertain times. Firstly, I'd like to thank the Australian federal and state governments for all their support over the past few years. We really wouldn't be where we are today if it wasn't for the assistance of these groups. We'd also like to thank our investors. DroneShield is an Australian-owned, publicly listed company on the ASX, and we're supported by hundreds of individual investors, most of whom are just everyday Australians, so I'd like to thank them a lot. I'd also like to thank every member of our Australian team and our US team as well. DroneShield is a growing STEM employer, which is very important, with over 40 engineers across multiple disciplines, including electrical, software engineering, artificial intelligence, machine learning, designing and manufacture. It's great to see high technology companies being recognised in Australia, and congratulations to all the nominees for the great work that they're also doing. Truly awesome seeing Australian technology growing and seeing those capabilities move overseas.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Lyle, because this is an area dominated internationally by the big boys, massive conglomerates around the world. DroneShield, what gives you the flexibility to take them on? What's your edge?
Oh, that's a fantastic question. I mean, so DroneShield works very closely with our partners in primes and in government. So obviously we can't discredit their contribution, but the Australian team is incredibly agile. The way that we manage the company is ensures that people have a huge amount of autonomy and support to do great technology, and that's fundamentally what we're here for. So we just focus on building cool stuff and moving as the customer needs it, producing products in an agile manner.
That should be your marketing slogan. We build cool stuff. Lyle, congratulations. I follow your stock. As Lyle was saying, it's listed on the stock exchange and it's a favourite on our business channel that I'm on. So, mate, congratulations to DroneShield, and don't forget to stick around for the big one, the Australian Exporter of the Year.
Okay, thank you very much.
Our next category is agribusiness, food and beverages. This is for outstanding international success in the field of agricultural products, services or technology, including farm production, manufactured foods and beverages, forestry and fisheries. Let's welcome the sponsor of this category, Adam Rowe, Head of Trade Finance from Commonwealth Bank of Australia. Adam is here to tell us more about their great support and announce the finalists for this year.
Cheers, Koshy. The Commonwealth Bank of Australia are delighted to support the Australian Export Awards. Through our Global Commodities and Trade and Working Capital Departments, CBA support the domestic and international trade and supply chain transactional flows of our domestic and international business, banking, corporate and institutional clients. We partner with organisations to deliver innovative and integrated solutions that are tailored to their business's ambitions for growth and efficiency. These departments provide specialist trade products and services to the business bank, private bank and institutional customers with support from relationship executives with product sales and structuring expertise. Let's see the finalists for this year. 2GR Wagyu Beef, New South Wales. Accolade Wines, South Australia. CBH Grain, Western Australia. Diversity Arrays Technology, the Australian Capital Territory. High Form Australia, Victoria. Kilcoy Global Foods, Queensland. Monsoon Aquatics, Northern Territory. Tasmanian Oyster Company, Tasmania. Good luck to you all.
Now, the winner of the Agribusiness Food and Beverage Award is Monsoon Aquatics. Oh, guys, congratulations to you all at Monsoon Aquatics. You've started the party early, which is fabulous. Now, you've got a vision in sharing the beauty and the wonder of the coral reef with the world, help people understand and develop a passion for coral and reefs, making them much more likely to protect it and invest in research. Daniel, how do you feel seeing that vision honoured tonight on the big stage?
Mate, we're stoked. It's unreal. I don't think I can put it into words. The passion we have for what we do, the team that we have, this is a really big pat on the back, and it's amazing.
What's been your secret to getting that export success?
Oh, I think it's probably doing what others aren't willing to do. It's the after-hours work. It's the responsiveness to customers. It's taking risks and being prepared when an opportunity presents itself and jumping on it.
When you look back at your journey, is there one particular moment with exports that you look back and go, geez, that was our turning point?
Almost every single export we do is a miracle. we're literally shipping live sensitive corals around the world. You know, we've got to put up with flight delays, with handling, with a whole range, you know, paperwork and legal paperwork and a whole range of things. So every time it's kind of like a little bit of a miracle.
Yeah, well, I tell you what, all those miracles have added up to this award tonight. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Now, this next category reflects outstanding international success across all creative industries, including music and performing arts, film, television and radio, software and interactive content such as virtual reality and augmented reality, writing, publishing and print media, and architecture, design and visual arts, including fashion design. I'd like to welcome the Chief Executive Officer of Screen Producers Australia, Matt Diener, who will announce the finalists. But first, Matt, tell us how your business supports exporters.
Look, thanks, Koshy, and it's a real pleasure to be with you all tonight. Look, we're a body that assists trade for the screen industry, and we're in such an important moment right now where the opportunities for our stories to be told globally are so big because of the large international streaming platforms that we're all watching. Look, we work on ensuring that there's supporting policy frameworks that assist our industry to really tell our stories globally, and that assists us economically. And I think it provides a really good halo for the rest of our world and our Australian industries more broadly. So that's great. Look, the finalists for the Creative Industries Award are the Cobalt Design from Victoria, Doc from New South Wales, Next Level Racing from Queensland, the Mighty Kingdom Games from South Australia, Ormsby Guitars from WA, and Wild Bear Entertainment from ACT. Fantastic and good luck.
Gee, that's an impressive list of finalists, isn't it? Our winner for 2021 Creative Industries Award is Wild Bear Entertainment. Now, Wild Bear achieved phenomenal success this year with the film Playing with Sharks. Did you see that, profiling shark conservationist Valerie Taylor being snapped up by National Geographic for Disney Plus after appearing at the Sundance Film Festival? Michael, you're joining us now. Mate, congratulations. How does achieving such success and then recognition here at the Export Awards, how does it feel in such a hard year? Oh, hang on, Michael. We'll just see if we can fix your audio at your end. We're not hearing you. How's that? Try again.
We're equal parts.
Ah, there you go.
And welcome. And shocked.
Yep, we've got you again now.
Okay, great. And yeah, it's been an incredibly tough year, not just for us, for everyone who's in the exporting community. I think that it shows how remarkably adaptive our business has been. Not only have we had the challenges of, you know, selling our content internationally, but at making things with shutdowns and just the level of teamwork that it goes to bringing every project to the market. It's been a hard year, but this is incredibly rewarding and satisfying and a great sort of end to what's been a tough 12 months.
Yeah, absolutely. What is it with sharks? I have a daughter that's addicted to Shark Week on the National Geographic Channel and loves your documentary.
Well, there is something incredibly, equal part, I guess, terrifying, but they're an awesome creature. And the amazing thing about Valerie's story is how she really challenged our understanding of sharks, and she was prepared to step into the water with them. And also, I mean, the incredible thing was that she was doing that in a man's world. you know, 40 or 50 years ago, and then she built an amazing career as a successful filmmaker. And that story, I think, now particularly is resonating with audiences. And I'm sure, you know, there is something, the footage of her swimming in open water with sharks is mesmerising, and I encourage everyone to have a look on Disney Plus.
And absolutely beautifully shot, and congratulations to you and your crews as well. It was just an outstanding effort. Congratulations again on winning the Creative Industries Award. Up next is e-commerce. This category is for outstanding success by an Australian business in selling goods or services to customers overseas via an electronic network, including cross-border e-commerce and online sales. Australia Post is the proud sponsor of this category. I'd like to welcome their General Manager of International Product and Portfolio Development from Australia Post, Lucy Watson-Jones. Lucy, tell us a bit about Australia Post's support for exporters and also these awards.
Thanks, Koshy, and hello, everyone. We're so thrilled to be supporting these awards for another year, and it was so wonderful to read the applications from the amazing finalists in this category. Australia Post, probably better known for the support we do for our domestic e-commerce, but less so for cross-border, and partnering with Austrade and sponsoring this category is a really great, great way for us to get closer to what small businesses are doing and what challenges they have. And speaking of challenges, you know, we're first and foremost provide international logistics, which has been hugely challenging over the past couple of years, but it's been fantastic to see the continued growth of consumers buying from merchants here in Australia and the growth of our businesses here in Australia. There's still a huge opportunity. We're thrilled to be helping those businesses. And the finalists in the e-commerce category are AussieNet, Clean and Pure, Delishu, Milton and King, Modi Body, Scoop Boot, and SK Designs. Good luck to all the finalists and congratulations.
And the winner of the Australian Export Awards e-commerce award is Clean and Pure. Mark Chapman, I love it that we're in the storeroom and the export hub of the business here. There, you've seen some phenomenal results, a 1,000% increase in online sales following a passionate customer championing your product. How incredible is it to see the impact of the support and advocacy of customers and making a difference like that?
Look, it's great. Look, I really think that the Australia brand and natural products is, you know, it's a big trend. It's always been there. And the pandemic forced us down the e-commerce road. And that meant that we got to, you know, we could go to more places faster than traditional exporting. So, yeah, it's been great.
Well, I love your colleague just behind you, still packing and they're working hard. Have you told him you've won the award yet? Let them know.
No, they've got to keep working, Koshy, mate.
Oh,
you know, we're a timesheet here, mate, yeah?
In a business like yours, Brand Australia, how important is it? Because the Australian brand is like a prestige product, a prestige brand, isn't it, to have associated with your own products?
Look, we actually carried out surveys because we didn't understand why we were being successful. It's hard to zero in. So we actually carried out surveys on our customers and we found that people were buying not because they loved Australia, although I'm sure they did, but specifically they were buying because they could trust Australia. And if an Australia logo was on there, they knew that the ingredients were what we said they were. And we had a good regulatory environment that we had to produce to a certain standard. And so the Australian-made logo gave us trust around the world. So.
Yeah, that is a really good lesson for all exporters. Mate, congratulations on winning the award, the e-commerce award. Now, come on, turn around and tell them you won. A big cheer.
Hey, come on, everybody.
There you go. Excellent.
I love it. Oh, you're doing a bit of surgery there? No, not at all. Is this an employee or a relative?
I better not say. No, it's my wife. It's my wife.
Good to see. Congratulations again on winning the e-commerce award, and fabulous to see it. Good on you. Oh, what a great story. We've had some fantastic wins already, and we've seen the support coming through on the app as well. Thank you for sending through your comments. Let's take a look at some of them now. Jacob says, congratulations to all finalists and well done for pushing hard through a tough year and a half. Christina says she loves watching Australians punch above their weight. I agree with you, Christine. Good luck to everyone. Jane Kelly says best of luck to all finalists. Advanced Bentleys and C-Max are holding an event on Ghana land. And great comments from everyone. Keep sending them through. Be part of it because it is... The exporting community is a really big, close, supportive and inspiring community. So stay in touch. Stay tuned. We've got so much more to come, including the highest accolade for exporters in the country, the big one, the 2021 Australian Exporter of the Year. We're keen to hear which industry or sector you think is going to take home the big award tonight. Let us know on the chat and send through all the details. Our next award is Emerging Exporter for Outstanding Export Achievement by an enterprise in any industry sector which has been exporting goods or services for 3 years or less. This award is sponsored by Qantas Freight, and I'd like to welcome their Regional Sales Manager, Penny Ford. Penny, before you get to the finalists in this category, tell us a bit about Qantas Freight's support for exporters.
More than a century ago, Qantas pioneered air travel, and our first flight all those years ago took mail and packages across Queensland. So our history is tied to air freight. We've been delivering shipments across Australia and to global markets for more than 100 years, and we love the part that we play in helping other pioneering Australian businesses take their goods overseas. As an exporter, you're creating new markets and making your mark on the global landscape. So wherever your journey takes you, together with our freight forwarding partners, we'll be ready to help you on the flying kangaroo. And the finalists for the Emerging Exporter Award category are Bentley's R&D Incentives, South Australia, Headsafe, New South Wales, Lorini Estate Distilling, Tasmania, Packform, Victoria, Kenton, ACT, Prohelion, Queensland, and Red Piranha, Western Australia.
Thanks, Penny, and a great lineup again of finalists. Really inspiring. The winner of the 59th Australian Export Awards Emerging Exporter is Penton. Congratulations to Penton and Matthew. Cyber technology, such a fast-paced sector, ripe with opportunities. How do you feel as an award-winning emerging exporter now, finding yourself honoured tonight?
Koshi, I think you asked me how we felt as an award-winning exporter.
Yep.
So I'm going to say it is genuinely, truly an honour to be up here today. It's been some trying times over the last couple of years, as most of us have been experiencing. But it's kind of moments like these that give the team the opportunity to be able to kind of celebrate the hard work that's kind of led to the success that we're now enjoying. Okay. So, no, I'm very excited to be up here.
Yeah, an emerging exporter, it's less than 3 years. How big a leap was it for you to get into the export market? Was it scary? Did you have a great blueprint?
Koshi, again, I'm not 100% sure what you asked me. The audio's a bit rough here in Ngunnawal country at the moment, but I'm gonna suggest that you're asking me how we went about doing it, and it was genuinely a kind of challenging process for us to think about how we would build our own export story. Our customer base is focusing on kind of military and government customers. It is a challenging, and from Australia, not necessarily a traditional market that we go after. We've been very lucky to be able to be supported and recognised with our technologies with the UK government, and putting ourselves in a position where we've more than trebled the exports that we did last year from what we did the year before.
Okay, so AUKUS is certainly going to be good for you. Matthew, congratulations again.
Thank you, Koshy.
Now up next, we have international education and training. This category is for outstanding international success or learner student experience in the field of education and training services, expertise and curriculum, including vocational training. We're absolutely thrilled to have ANZ sponsor this award, and joining me now is Managing Director International, Simon Ireland. Simon, welcome. Before you get to the finalists, tell us about your support for the Australian Export Awards.
Thank you. We are proud to support the Australian Export Awards. Our sponsorship is an opportunity for us to further assist Australian exporters, which is linked to our aim to help companies move goods and capital around the region using our global network of 32 markets. The awards also provide a chance to recognise Australian businesses that have been successful in realising their international growth aspirations and showcase the many export possibilities available to businesses which may be looking to expand overseas. As well as using our network of 32 markets to connect Australian exporters to the many opportunities across our region, we are focused on digital transformation of the trade and supply chains. We are introducing more efficient, innovative, multi-bank solutions along with blockchain technologies to make doing business simpler for exporters. We also aim to bring customers technical, logical, and global industry knowledge and provide creative solutions to the most complex challenges. Exporters need a reliable partner to help them not just operate within their home country and across the region, but also to innovate, manage their risk, and grow. This is what we aim to be for our customers. So, the finalists for the Australian Export Awards International Education and Training Award are Alana Kay College, Northern Territory; Capital College, Australian Capital Territory; Engineering Institute of Technology, Western Australia; Global Study Partners, New South Wales; NIET Group, Queensland; and TIPSI, Victoria. Good luck to everyone in this category. Thank you.
Now, the winner of the International Education and Training Award is Engineering Institute of Technology. Ah, Edwina, best reaction so far. Congratulations. How does it feel to win this award?
Koshy, I seem to be looking away from you, but we are so excited and so honoured and delighted. And thank you, big team all over the world, for assisting us achieve this tonight. We haven't been able to hear very well, unfortunately, so I don't know what your question was, but I would just like to say I think it has been our incredible supportive and online platform that is interactive and well supported by our staff everywhere, which has allowed us to continue through these very difficult couple of years, something we established in 2008 and continue to hone and develop. And it is absolutely amazing that we can take Australian qualifications and reach students all over the world and empower them and their communities, and we're very proud of that. And I love that our staff have just embraced it and always ensure that the student is at the heart of everything we do. Thank you very much to everybody.
Oh, good on you, Edwina. Congratulations. It really is terrific, and congratulations once again on the award. All right, right, let's go from education to our next award, which is International Health. This recognises outstanding international success in medical, healthcare, biotechnology fields for products, technology and equipment or services. This includes e-health, digital health, medtech and also aged care services. I'm delighted to be joined by the Chief Executive Officer of Life Science Queensland, Claire Blaine, to present the award. Claire, tell us why you support the awards and who are the finalists.
Thank you, Koshi. I'm delighted to be here. LSQ really supports the Export Awards because it's just so important to recognise and to celebrate innovative Australian exporters who have achieved amazing growth and success whilst contributing back to the Australian economy. The finalists of the Australian Export Awards International Health category are Avans Clinical, South Australia, Epichem, Western Australia, Imaging Solutions, Queensland, Invitech, Victoria, Cellborn Biological Services, Tasmania, TARPI, New South Wales. Good luck to everyone in this category.
The winner of the Australian Export Awards International Health Award in 2021 is Invitech. Invitech have leveraged Australian technology and know-how for international clients by creating solutions that detect COVID-19 and support the fight against cancer. Andreas, how does it feel to be recognised at the national level for your contribution to your sector, to the Australian economy and also to global health?
Koshi, first of all, I'm absolutely stoked and I'm hardly able to express what I'm feeling here on behalf of my team. We're so incredibly proud of this award. I also couldn't quite hear your question, but we had an incredible 2 years. As for any exporter, it's been really hard. It's been really hard doing this job, serving clients, providing professional services, especially has been super hard when not being able to be with clients, to see clients, and to acquire new clients. And we have to be very, very agile, stick to our strategy, and work incredible hours. Our team has worked so incredibly hard. Their tenacity and their client service, their focus on keeping customers happy has been remarkable. In that way, we've been able to, under very adverse circumstances, do very rewarding work in fighting both COVID-19 as well as cancer. So we had an amazing 2 years.
Yep, incredible success. Congratulations again. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks.
Now, the Australian Export Awards Hall of Fame was established in 2002. It recognises the exporters that have achieved success in their field time and time again. For the exporters watching, if you win in your category on 3 occasions, you too could be inducted into the Hall of Fame. I'd like to welcome back Austrade Chief Executive Xavier Simonet to present this prestigious honour.
It takes imagination, adaptability and deep expertise to be inducted into the Australian Export Awards Hall of Fame. Previous inductees are shining stars in their fields, a blue chip constellation of big hitters that have demonstrated enduring export success and made a long-term contribution to the nation's economic prosperity. Of course, this honour goes beyond recognising job creation and the generation of export income. It recognises teamwork. It recognises leadership. It recognises cultures of excellence. This year's inductee has built a global brand with social purpose by leading the field in providing global healthcare solutions to remote, challenging and under-resourced environments. The Canberra-based company, founded in 2003, is no stranger to awards. It has won 3 Australian Export Awards, 4 ACT Exporter of the Year Awards, and a long line of industry awards recognising innovation and excellence across many facets of service delivery. Tonight, it adds another significant entry to its long list of achievements. It is my great pleasure to announce Aspen Medical as the Export Awards Hall of Fame inductee for 2021.
Congratulations to Aspen Medical. And with you in Canberra, we have Brendan Smith, Commissioner for International Engagement, ACT Government, to present you with a certificate on behalf of the Australian Trade and Commission and Australian Chamber of Commerce and Industry. Brendan.
I'd like to begin by thanking the Australian Trade and Investment Commission, the Australian Chamber of Commerce and Industry, and the ACT Government for their collective support over the years. Aspen Medical was born exporting, with all of our first contracts awarded overseas. The world sees us as an exporter of healthcare expertise, world-class project management skills, innovative healthcare solutions, medical technology, clinic management, and aeromedical retrieval services, amongst many other things. But when it all boils down to it for us, we believe that what we export is Australian compassion, making healthcare better for people where others can't and where it's desperately needed. On the flip side, the lessons that we have learnt and the networks that we've built during our exporting experience have allowed us to expand on our import capability and then answer this country's call during the pandemic. We've been able to support Australia in so many ways, including importing PPE, medical devices, and critical services and support. Indeed, the requirement to import PPE led us to create a sovereign manufacturing capability in Queensland last year, and this in turn is already leading to more export opportunities for us and for Australia. As the first Canberra company to be inducted into the National Exporters Hall of Fame, and on behalf of all of my colleagues from Aspen Medical across the world, I want to, and they are all working critically to provide healthcare wherever it's needed, I thank all of you involved for this wonderful honour. Thank you.
And Glenn, before you go, can we have the microphone back? It's Koshy here. That's Brendan. All right, we've now... there we go. Glenn, are you getting us? It's Koshy here.
Can see you, Koshy. Thank you.
Can you hear me? What's been your most...
I can hear you, clear as
perfect.
A bell.
What's been your most memorable or rewarding moment from your involvement with the Export Awards over the years?
Look, it's been a journey for us on the Export Awards. I think the memorable moment is seeing the incredible companies that are across Australia doing amazing work, often silently, diligently, you know, exporting Australia into the world. And I'm always stunned at every event I've been to at the breadth of scope of what Australia does. And it's said before, we punch above our weight, and we see that in every country we go to. Being an Australian is a door opener being an exporter.
Yep. Being in the Hall of Fame, you're now an export guru. For those exporters who are, you know, who get jaded and get disenchanted, what do you say to them to keep going? Because you've had tenacity in Aspen Medical to keep going and achieve and over some enormous hurdles.
Look, what you've got to do is look for the positives. There'll always be the naysayers, there'll be those dark nights, there'll be the times that you're unsure of yourself. But the reason that every single Australian company is in the Exporters Award is because they believe in themselves, they believe in their products, their services, and how the world will be a better place for when they deliver that outside Australia and internationally. Believing in themselves, understanding that, will get you through those dark moments to the success the other side.
Glenn, really an inspiring story from Aspen Medical. Congratulations on the win.
Thanks so much, Koshy. It's fantastic.
Wow. That is so inspiring, isn't it? We've had an amazing night of winners so far. Let's take a look at the celebrations coming through on the app. Gab says that they love seeing Australian emerging exporters making waves on the world stage. Absolutely, Gab. Christina says she sees such joy in the face of winners. That could be Mark Chapman with a big kiss from his wife. And congratulations to the Engineering Institute of Technology. Josh says congratulations to Penton and great to see a young export business thrive. It sure is. Make sure to tell us in the chat which industry, though, or sector you all think is going to take home Exporter of the Year award tonight. Now, our next category is manufacturing and advanced materials, recognising outstanding international success in manufacturing, engineering and advanced materials development, including production of consumer products. Our sponsor of the Manufacturing and Advanced Materials Award is Australian Made Campaign, which has a long-standing relationship with the Australian Export Awards. I'd like to welcome their Chief Executive Officer, Ben Lazzaro, to tell us why you support the awards and might announce the finalists.
Thanks, David. Really great to be here. Australian Made has always taken great delight in helping to shine a light on Australia's manufacturers and exporters. By supporting the Australian Export Awards, we can help celebrate the achievements, growth, and successes of these fantastic Australian exporters. The finalists in the Australian Export Awards Manufacturing and Advanced Minerals category 2021 are Austrade, Western Australia, Australian Blue Cypress, Northern Territory, AW Bell, Victoria, Ignite Digi, Tasmania, Lightforce Australia, South Australia, Riviera Australia, Queensland, Turbo Smart, New South Wales. Good luck to all the finalists tonight.
And the winner is, well, there isn't one. The National Judging Panel have come up with two equally compelling and equally scored nominees, both very worthy winners. Therefore, our joint winners for the Manufacturing and Advanced Materials Award are AW Bell and Riviera Australia. It's a double. Congratulations to you both. Sam, come on forward. Let's start with you. Innovation and ingenuity has seen AW Bell successfully pass through three generations and evolved from pattern makers to automotive supplier, today to advanced precision metal parts manufacturing for aerospace and defence. How thrilling is it to witness that evolution of AW Bell and see it culminate tonight?
It's amazing to see the business develop and grow to where we are today. We're very proud to win the award, very unexpected. The business has developed out of that automotive industry and into the aerospace and defence. And it's really been on the back of businesses telling us what we can't do. Huh. And it's that Australian competitive streak that says if someone tells you you can't do something, you go and do it.
Give me an example.
A lot of our customers
that
have come and said, yep, give it a shot, but you're competing against the biggest companies in the world and we don't think you've got a chance. And we've proven ourselves wrong and transitioned the business. Where we are today.
Give us an example of that, of someone that has said, yep, nah, you can't do that, give it a go.
On the S35 program, we're supplying some very complex parts and our customer was having challenges 7 years into the program. And they came to us and said, well, you can give it a shot, but you've got to fund it yourselves. You won't be able to do it. You won't be able to cast it. You won't be able to machine it. And here's a $0 purchase order. And if you can do it, we'll order more. And we produce them five sets of components. And 7 years later, we're a single source on that program.
Jeez, they're a tough customer. Did you feel like telling them to get nicked early on?
We're lucky we didn't because they're now our biggest customer. and allowing the business to grow. But we were close at times, definitely.
Well, that is a great story. Hey, who's behind you? Is that the team behind you?
That is the team behind us. So we've got Vinesh, Commercial Director, Richard, who's our Manufacturing Manager, Sam, who's Business Development Manager, and our Senior Technical Specialist, Dr. Roger Lumley.
Okay. Mate, put away the beers. Break out the champagne. It's a great award to win. Congratulations.
We will. Thank you very much. Congratulations to the others.
Yeah, yeah.
Riviera. Well done, Riviera.
Rodney, to you, the long-term success and popularity of Riviera Luxury Motor Yacht sees more than half of your annual production heading overseas each year. What are the key elements? And because you guys have been going 41 years, what have been the key elements to your success? Unmute, Rodney. Yep, just there we go. We've all done it.
You hear me now?
Yep, we can.
Okay, great. Thank you. It's all about the people. We have a fantastic team here of over 900, and we're obsessive, we're driven, creative, we're gritty, and, you know, we just go hard every day. And, you know, our exporting right now is, in fact, over 60% overseas.
Goodness me. Even in this environment of border lockdowns and the like?
That's made it extremely hard. And we have to source components from around the world to put our amazing motor yachts together. So that's another challenge. But, you know, we're a tough Aussie battler and having a go.
Yep. And because you've got a lot of competition out of Asia now, don't you? Sort of cheaper, more inferior boats, but you're doing better than ever.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we really don't compete with the inferior product. We're looking to be, you know, amongst the best in the business. And we are competing against, you know, billionaire-backed companies, but we're competing with the best of Europeans and the best of the Americans, and we can stand proudly beside them. It's a fantastic story for our whole team. It really is great.
Yeah, congratulations. Made a big night for you, winning an export award. Have you got a discount for any of us watching?
Oh, I'm sure that the boat behind us, Koshy, we'd be happy to take you out on that if you can make yourself available.
I meant off the purchase price, not a trip. All right, mate, congratulations both to Riviera and AW Bell. What outstanding joint winners for this category. Up next is Minerals, Energy and Related Services. This award recognises outstanding international success in the production, processing, value-adding of extractive resources or provision of equipment, services or solutions related to the mining, oil and gas and renewables industries. Our sponsor of this category is Minerals Council of Australia. Joining me is General Manager Trade and Investment, Demas King. Over to you, Demas, to announce the finalists for this category. First, tell us a little about your support for these awards.
Thanks, Koshy. The Australian mining industry is made up of large and small businesses, from the miners themselves to the Australian companies and family businesses that provide the services to a global industry. Environmental services, safety, engineering, data, the list is long. Whether they mine or provide technical and other services, they each make up an important contribution to Australia's trade competitiveness and Australia's trade success story. These awards provide the opportunity to recognise and celebrate the incredible innovation, the expertise, the cleverness, and the commitment of those Australian businesses who take the huge step to compete on a global stage. The finalists in the Australian Export Awards Minerals, Energy and Related Services category are Dexter Proprietary Limited, Australian Capital Territory, Concept New South Wales, NLT Digital Solutions Queensland, Safe Escape Victoria, Western X Supply, Western Australia, Over to you, Koshy, to announce this year's winner.
Thanks, Demas, and the Minerals Council of Australia for their ongoing support. The winner of the Minerals, Energy and Related Services category is Concep. Ah, Grant Stewart, congratulations, you and the team and the dog there, looking very attractive with the kerchief. Is that the lucky charm or mascot?
Yes, mate, comes in every day, looks after us.
Perfect. Congratulations. What's the main factor you credit to achieving such phenomenal success globally?
Well, mate, we follow the gold industry around the world. So we'll go where, you know, gold starts economies. You know that. Yep. Basically, anywhere there's a new country that needs to stimulate its economy, they put in a gold mine. So we go in there, tell them how to, and help them how to recover, help them how to get more recoveries than they've done before, and get it out in the cheapest way possible.
Okay, tell us the most obscure, the most far-reaching customer that you've had to work with.
Well, I think it's where over in Zimbabwe where Jimmy had to stand in front of 40 hippos in one of our shops or so. Where was that?
That was Tanzania.
Tanzania?
Yeah.
Right. With a customer that hardly had any resources. So we were on the fridge. We were on about 200 metres from the Ebola virus when that was all around. We had to go to Freeport just after they had a shooting of all the teachers one year. We've been to some pretty brave places, and this team never falters. They'll go up and go anywhere. So we don't send people where they're going to be in danger, but everybody knows the importance of what we're doing, and we always stand up.
Hippos, Ebola, riots. COVID must seem a walk in the park for you guys.
Well, it was actually. I mean, we basically said we were going to thrive during this time, and we actually doubled our sales over this period of time. So it wasn't easy, but everybody pulled in. Yeah, we're an Australian manufacturer, so half of our staff is actually blue collar, and they pulled in through it and came every day. So as the LGAs were coming and shutting people down, we were recalculating how we were going to meet all this demand. So it was a very trying time, but we pulled through, and to get this success is just, it's an amazing thing. So we've got to thank everybody so much. We're over the moon.
Amazing. Well, that tenacity has got you this award and an amazing result. Who, apart from the dog and our hippo watcher, who have you got behind you in the team?
Sorry, mate, we missed that. But we've got people from every department here. We've got Paddy that was up on buildings in North Sydney today helping with our hoists. We helped build the World Trade Centre. We've got Phil that's designed every piece of equipment over the last 20 years. Jimmy that's been everywhere. Brendan that sells everything. Pete that travels around WA. Kate, that anybody in WA needs a spare part, she knows exactly what it is. Paul, that's been over there redesigning Canada's electrical systems, and Shane as well, that look, make sure we don't spend too much money.
Well, that is fantastic, because these awards recognise teams and the human beings, the faces behind it. Congratulations again to Concept and the Minerals Council of Australia. An award well deserved.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Our next award is Professional Services, which celebrates outstanding international success in professional business services, including legal, financial and insurance, management, marketing and administration, franchising and licensing, engineering, market research and translation. Joining me from the Australian Chamber of Commerce and Industry, our awards co-presenter, is Chief Executive Officer Andrew McKellar. Andrew, over to you to announce the finalists for this category.
Well, look, thanks very much, Koshy, and indeed, Aki is absolutely delighted to be a co-presenter of these awards and to continue our association with the awards, which has been in place for us since 1964. That's 1 year after the awards started. So we're really delighted to be able to continue to support something that really sets the benchmark in terms of a key pathway to business success, the ability to export. So, Koshy, this year, the finalists in the professional services category, I'm pleased to announce, firstly, OET from Victoria, CMAX clinical research from South Australia, Contract Electrical Queensland from Queensland, Link Digital from the ACT, Metallurgical Systems from New South Wales, and Orway IQ from Western Australia.
Thank you for that. The 2021 winner of the Professional Services Award is CMAX Clinical Research. Congratulations to CMAC Clinical Research. Jane, where are you? What's the main factor you credit to achieving such phenomenal success over the last year?
This incredible team that are surrounding me, and there's 275 staff that work now at CMAC. So we've had something like a 27% growth in the last 12 months, but 43% growth in the last 3 years. So a phenomenal team. Working incredibly hard and showing incredible resilience. So okay. Particularly during COVID, and we have worked on quite a number of COVID programs. We've completed four, we've got two in progress and two in startup, and many more to come, I think. So we're probably a good example of, you know, COVID has increased the demand for clinical trials, and it's not just with CMAX, but with in Australia. So but, you know, it's a great example of what a fabulous team we've got here in Adelaide.
Yep. Give us an example of the export market you have been most proudest to crack.
Yeah, so historically, all of our work really has come from international markets. So over 90% is international, predominantly from the US market. But, you know, we've seen a big increase over recent years in the Asia-Pac region, so coming from China, coming from Japan, Taiwan, Korea. And with COVID, we've seen an increase also from Europe. So it's just been pleasing getting that message. And, you know, we work very hard in selling clinical trials to the world. So it's really selling, you know, Australia to the world and then selling South Australia from there.
Is this usual Thursday night drinks to get the French champagne out and the pastries?
But coincidentally, we're actually taking this from our brand new headquarters, which we actually had the South Australian Premier, the Honourable Stephen Marshall, open today.
Whereabouts?
So this afternoon. So it's been a big day here at CMAX.
Whereabouts? Where are you based? Of course, Stephen's a great Port Adelaide supporter.
So we're located, we're very lucky, we're directly opposite Adelaide Biomed City and directly across from the new Royal Adelaide Hospital. So we've had a building sort of behind down a side street. We've now got the headquarters in the front building, and they fabulously built a bridge that's six stories up to connect the two buildings. So we've got the best view from our balcony. So we have the envy of the state.
And that's become a real medical hub, hasn't it? That end of North Terrace, it's just wonderful.
Yeah, and we're very lucky with that. So we've got brand new facilities directly across the road. We've got all the clever people down this end of town. So it's great for us to collaborate on clinical research. So it's a really good, and South Australia needs to actually be, we need to blow our trumpet a little bit more. We need to get out there and tell people what we actually achieve here in the state. So. Yep.
I totally agree.
Very proud of this team and very proud to be in Adelaide.
Okay, I'm flying over there for a bit of inspiration tomorrow, so I'll give you a wave as I drive by. Congratulations on that outstanding win.
Thank you so much.
Now, the next award is Regional Exporter, recognising outstanding international success by a business whose head office is based in a non-metropolitan location. Our proud sponsor of this category is the Department of Agriculture, Water and the Environment. Please welcome Secretary Andrew Metcalf. Andrew, tell us why the department supports the Export Awards, and while you're at it, go through the finalists.
Good evening, everyone. The Department of Agriculture, Water and the Environment is committed to enhancing Australia's agriculture, our environment, our heritage and our water resources through regulation and through partnerships. So I'm proud that we're a long-standing sponsor of the regional exporter category, recognising businesses that promote growth in regional Australia. The Australian Export Awards provide important national recognition for businesses across all sectors, and we're so proud to be involved in recognising those businesses that are as committed to enhancing Australia's precious resources as we are. My department assists industries to accelerate towards a $100 billion agriculture sector by 2030. An important part of this is the Agribusiness Expansion Initiative, or ABI. Key elements of the initiative overseen by the department include match grants for government and industry associations to work together on market expansion, boosted in-country engagement activities, accelerated work on technical market access, and greater collection and delivery of market intelligence to exporters. The finalists for the Australian Export Award Regional Exporter are Air Physio, New South Wales; Asia Pacific Aircraft Storage, Northern Territory; Beck Hardy Wines, South Australia; Blue Hills Honey, Tasmania; Care Essentials, Victoria; Derby Industries, Western Australia; Garlicious Growen, Australian Capital Territory; Morton Co, Queensland. Good luck to you all.
Yep, it is a family affair, every export business, isn't it? Great to see the kids involved. The Regional Exporter Award goes to Air Physio. Congratulations to Air Physio. As an exporter based in a regional area, how did you develop those relationships with so many countries?
It wasn't easy to start off with, but COVID actually changed the mindset in relation to using Zoom instead of having to fly over to come and meet them.
Yeah, so Paul, while we were all sort of getting used to doing Zoom meetings and muting ourselves at the wrong time or having weird people walk behind us, it actually proved a boost for your business.
It did. It's been phenomenal. Zoom's actually helped us to grow to 85 countries, up from about 5 last year, actually, and about 50 countries since March.
Hang on. 5 to 85 in a year?
Just over a year, yes.
Oh, my goodness. That is for – where are you based?
Just in South Tweed, south of the Gold Coast.
And tell us about some of your clients. What do you provide them?
We actually sell B2C and also B2B respiratory therapy devices to help them to breathe easier.
Right.
It's a medical device.
Okay. Tell us about the team around you. Who have you got there with you?
I've got Natalie here, who's our brand manager. This is my wife, who makes sure that we actually don't overspend. Andrew, who's our COO. Ethan, who's our marketing manager. The rest of them have actually all gone home for the evening.
Oh, they have little faith. When they come back tomorrow, you can say, let me tell you what you missed out. And, of course, you're going to shout the team that stayed, aren't you? A celebratory drink.
Oh, Definitely. Okay. Yes.
All right. Now, Mrs. O'Brien, tell me what it's like to keep him under control.
Wow.
Good chance.
Where do I start? I'm just blown away by what my husband does each and every day. He surprises me. His knowledge and his passion for not just our business but our workforce, he treats everyone like family. So, that's what I'm really proud of.
Hang on, it's not just about him, it's about you too. You know, you run the finances and the business side, and as every exporter knows, yes, you can have great products and services to export, but the business has got to run smoothly as well. How have you coped with that many, having to deal with that many new countries so many different currencies and transactions?
It's definitely been a challenge learning on our feet. And, international finance now. And, I've had to bring on a lot of people in our team. So, but we've kept it as family and as well. So I've got my sister and our eldest daughter and other staff I'm working with now on the finance and payroll. So, yeah.
That is
They proved to actually work, and so we did actually let them come into the business.
Yeah. Well, congratulations to you both. Outstanding. 5 to 85 countries in a year. Extraordinary. Congratulations on being the regional exporter.
Thanks, Koshy.
Sorry, I'm going a bit over here, but how easy is it to get carried away and inspired by all our winners? I just reckon it's fascinating to hear all of their stories. And we've got more to come. We only have two more awards until we announce the big one, the Australian Exporter of the Year. In the meantime, let's look at the Small Business Award for outstanding international success by any business with total annual sales under $10 million. I'd like to welcome our sponsor of this category, Managing Director and Chief Executive of Export Finance Australia, Swati Dave. Swati, before you announce the finalists of the small business category, why don't you tell us how Export Finance Australia supports our exporters?
Thanks, David. As the Australian Government's Export Credit Agency, our role is to finance exporters so they can grow and succeed internationally. We work closely with partners such as Austrade and the commercial banks to support exporters on this growth journey. We've sponsored these awards for the last 26 years, and many of our customers have been nominated and won these awards. And we're delighted to recognise and celebrate all these wonderful exporter achievements. Now, the finalists for the Australian Export Awards for the small business category are Apsium Technologies from South Australia, Aristotle Metadata from Australian Capital Territory, Dutch Ann Sandalwood Oils from Western Australia, Hill Farm Preserves from Tasmania, iBuild Building Solutions from Victoria, One Model from Queensland, and Twisted Healthy Treats from New South Wales. Thanks, David.
And the winner of the Small Business Award is iBuild Building Solutions. Jackson, congratulations to you and iBuild Building Solutions. You've won in the small business category with some big ideas, though. Give us your tips for fellow small businesses out there on how to take your business to greater heights.
Well, thanks, Kosh. The tip we have is to be innovative and to be agile, particularly in light of the COVID. We need to be very adaptive to the new situation and boost the digital presence, particularly the search engine optimization, work on the 3D walkthrough VRs and ARs so that we can show our display homes virtually to the client around the world, rather than we can't in the past. We would use a physical display home to get our clients come here to potentially to conduct the sales activities. Because of COVID, now we're forced to do digitally, and that proved to be quite a rewarding experience.
Right. So go back to the very start. How did you come up with the idea of virtual reality walkthroughs to target overseas customers, and why has this been so effective?
We were a relatively small business. Building a display home is quite an expensive exercise. The COVID forced us to close down all our display walkthrough activities. Our team just thought we have to find other ways to reach our customers. I think the VR digital showroom will give us the edge now on the same level playing field with the big boys. So that's proven to be quite a rewarding experiment for us.
Yeah. Was it a bit nerve-wracking, as you were saying, taking on the big boys?
It is. It is, because we actually won our projects, one of clients in Senegal, in West Africa, working on a German foreign aid project, and then selected us to be a supplier of 11 homes to be shipped to West Africa for the German foreign aid project.
Wow, West Africa. Look, congratulations, Jackson, to iBuild Building Solutions. Well done. Go and celebrate. Don't forget the Australian Exporter of the Year Award is coming up and you're eligible for it. So stick around. Good to see you.
Thank you.
Now, the final category award is sustainability in recognition of outstanding international success in environmental solutions, clean energy innovation, materials and energy efficiency, as well as renewable energy, waste and water management, green buildings, smart cities and R&D collaboration. To present this award, please welcome the Deputy Director, Research Leader Northern Australia from the CSIRO Land and Water, Dr. Chris Chilcott. Chris was also one of the category judges too, and I look forward to hearing your insight on that. Over to you.
Great. Thanks, David. As Australia's national science agency, CSIRO is all about taking smart ideas and creating impact. These awards are all about recognising the entrepreneurs and private sector who take those smart ideas and turn them into products and service into emerging export markets. The finalists for the Australian Export Awards Sustainability category are Hydrobiology from Queensland, MetroCount from Western Australia, New South Wales, MicroBiogen, Plant Sensors from the Northern Territory, SunPower Renewables from Victoria, Red Arc Electronics from South Australia, the Malian Group, Australian Capital Territory, True South Seafood from Tasmania. Good luck to all in the category.
And the sustainability category winner is True South Seafood. Ah, congratulations, all you Taswegians. You're going wild there. The plans for your new factory sound really exciting, particularly in respect to restoring the marine ecosystems and using 100% renewable energy. What prompted you to diversify your export market?
Oh, look, we've got a goal of zero fish by 2025, Koshi, and we've seen as industry leaders in innovation and sustainability, and improving the condition of our marine ecosystems is absolutely one of our top priorities.
Yep. How have you grown the export markets over the last year or so?
Tenacity, grit, and diversification.
Yeah, explain that. Explain the diversification.
So, I'm turning an invasive marine species, which is the Central Stephanus sea urchin, into not only a world-class seafood product, which we export all over the world, but we're now turning the waste from that processing into an organic, viable fertiliser for agriculture industries. And we're doing that using 100% renewable energy.
I can sense your passion for this at a time where the industry is under a bit of focus, isn't it? The commercial fishing industry, about its environmental impact. You seem just so determined to turn that perception around.
Absolutely, because it's where we generate our business from. It supports a lot of families across regional areas in Tasmania, from the amazing people I've got behind me who are our employees to, our dive families who are sort of located around the state. And without this industry, without this
amazing natural resource without, you know, if we don't take steps to look after it, it's not going to be there for future generations. So, yeah.
Look, congratulations. Pass on our congratulations to the team behind you. You look a really close-knit bunch and you deserve every accolade.
Thanks, Koshy. They're awesome. It's all about these guys.
Good on you. Isn't that great? And I think one of the common themes about the awards tonight and every year is it is about great teams. And what an outstanding selection of finalists and winners we've been through. Now, we asked you earlier which industry or sector you think is going to take home the Exporter of the Year award. Let's see what you've said. Terry Young MP says, well done, everyone. Very proud to be Australian right now. I agree with you, Terry. So inspiring. Jared Emery says, congratulations to each category winner so far. It's clear that Australia has incredibly high-performing businesses. Chris McBride says, congratulations to all the finalists. What a great achievement in difficult circumstances. Emma says, so great to hear about these inspiring Aussie businesses in so many interesting industries taking it to the world. Emma, I reckon you're right. The industries from what we've had, drone shield technology to sea urchins and everything in between. It's extraordinary. All right. Now for the moment you've all been waiting for. Yes, indeed. It is the big one. Our final award for this evening, the Australian Exporter of the Year Award in recognition of the most outstanding Australian exporter for 2021. And we've seen so many great examples tonight. It's going to be incredibly hard to choose, I reckon. Let's please all welcome back the Honourable Dan Tehan to announce the finalists for this year and then, of course, the winner. Minister, it's a big one.
Koshy, great to be back. And wow, haven't we seen some great winners? And the emotion that has been on those faces has been almost brings tears to your eyes. You can see the passion that goes into those businesses and also the innovation that's been on display. Quite extraordinary. And the pursuit of diversification, something that the government's been pursuing, we've seen in all these businesses. So we've had a great night, but it's only going to get better. These awards go back to 1963. Hammersley Iron was the first award winner. And we've had Cochlear, we've had Argyle Diamonds, Lonely Planet, diversity in all the winners since 1963, and we're going to get diversity, I'm sure, again tonight. So, Koshy, let's have a look at all the winners from all the categories, because that's where our Exporter of the Year is going to come from. So back to you, and let's have a look at all those winners from each of those categories that we will choose the Australian Exporter of the Year from.
Physio, A.W. Bell, Clean and Pure, C-Max Clinical Research, Concept, Drone Shield, Engineering Institute of Technology, iBuild Building Solutions, Invitec, Monsoon Aquatics, Penten, Riviera Australia, True South Seafood, Wild Bear Entertainment.
So, Koshy, I've got the envelope here. I'm just opening it up, pulling the winner out. The suspense is killing me. I'm sure it's killing everyone else. This is incredibly exciting. And can I just say to everyone who's participated again tonight, thank you for being such a wonderful example to all our businesses, our export businesses right across Australia. And the winner of the 2021 Australian Exporter of the Year is Monsoon Aquatics from the Northern Territory. Well done, Monsoon Aquatics. Congratulations on a huge, huge achievement and incredibly well deserved. If I had a question, it is, and you mentioned this when you got your early award, how as a team did you come together to deal with the once in a century pandemic? This pandemic, none of us could see it coming. It's challenged us all. You've risen to the occasion. You're now the 2021 Australian Exporter of the Year. How have you dealt as a team with the pandemic, and what lessons would you have for exporters right across the nation for dealing with future challenges?
Well, first of all, thank you. We're amazed. We're quite shocked and very happy. COVID was devastating for us. Like, we rely on air freight and that just stopped overnight. And we have very quickly had to innovate, adapt and survive, just like Bear Grylls would. We followed that advice and we just worked hard. We had a lot of new initiatives that we brought forward and took some risks and worked hard. Yeah, it's not rocket science. There's no secrets. It's just grit, determination and being ready for the opportunities and recognising them and grabbing them.
Well, you've done that with spades, and I must say, nothing gives me greater pleasure than hearing that two words, hard work, because I think if anything underpins all our award winners tonight, fundamentally hard work and teamwork and innovation is at the key of what all of you have achieved. So congratulations. You go on an honour board which recognises the best of the best. It is thoroughly deserved. And I wish you all the very well in the future, and I know it will be a bright one. So thank you, all the best, and thanks again to everyone who has participated. Back to you, Koshy.
Good on you, Minister. Daniel, our congratulations as well. I can honestly say in the 55-year history of the Export Awards, no one has used Bear Grylls as their business model. But it is...
it's been like being at war, hasn't it? Survival situation with COVID and being in business. I mean, everyone who's in business, small or large, it's been tough.
Yep. Yeah. Exporting coral around the world, how satisfying is that for you to know that you're saving and exporting something so precious to the environment?
It's really important to us. Like, we honestly believe that sharing this beauty and wonder of the reef with the world actually gets people interested, willing to invest, willing to protect. And we're right now investing all of our profits into aquaculture. We've done some world first spawning events with really tricky species of coral. And we're going to be at the forefront of reef restoration and doing that habitat restoration in Australia as well. So
Wow. We're
really excited.
Just explain that a bit more to us, because we're constantly told about bleaching of the reef and we're going to lose one of our most prestigious resources in this country and most fragile. But you're working out just how to restore it and rebuild it. How?
Koshy, it's a mixture of science and magic at the moment and bucket chemistry, because we only know a certain amount about these coral species and what we're working on, the species we're working on, haven't been done before. We had a world first spawning in our Bundaberg facility a few weeks ago of a species that is endemic to Australia and has never been spawned before.
No.
So there's no textbooks, there's no scientific papers we can go and read. So we've got to take a little bit of what we know, what's been proven, and kind of apply a bit of magic and a bit of luck and a lot of hard work and, you know, cross our fingers.
Yeah, yeah. What started your passion for it?
Oh, mate, my father opened an aquarium store when I was a youngster. So my first memories are, you know, playing around with fish tanks, and I can't drive past a creek or an ocean without getting in and having a look. Yeah, it's an obsession. Yeah.
So who have you got with you there?
So I've got Tim behind me here. Tim's our skipper, and he's part business owner. So Tim runs our boat in the Northern Territory.
Yeah.
The most dangerous place in Australia to dive. And no one has dived more of the Northern Territory and explored it than Tim. Right. And then here I've got Sophie, who is our facility manager here in Darwin. And Sophie just runs an amazing operation here with our husbandry staff, our packers, and our sales team.
Yeah. Okay. Compared with Tim, your shirt's a bit plain. You've got to get a bit more colourful, I reckon.
I'm the business at the front, Tim's the party at the back. We're like a mullet.
Daniel, what an achievement to receive the award. Let's take a moment to acknowledge Monsoon Aquatic Success.
We really believe in sharing the beauty and the wonder of the coral reef with the world. What we're harvesting and growing on site here, our hope is that one day we can also be involved in reef restoration efforts. We are licensed exporters of live coral and fish for the worldwide aquarium trade. We're an important part of the Northern Territory and Darwin community. We supply wholesalers overseas, and we're in a unique position where the demand outstrips supply. What makes us special compared to other businesses that do what we do is our team and our passion. Everyone who works for us absolutely love dealing with marine life, corals and fish. Export's critical to our business. Without export, we wouldn't have the size of the company we do now. 80% of our product would be exported overseas. It's allowed us to become one of the biggest operators in Australia. So that's really where our future is, our growth. It's really exciting.
What an incredible business. What an achievement. Congratulations again, Monsoon Aquatics, on winning the 2021 Australian Exporter of the Year. And a big congratulations to all our winners and all our finalists. To those watching around the country, I hope you feel inspired by the stories we've heard tonight of exporters overcoming remarkable feats to take their products and services to the world. As a proud small business owner and exporter myself, I cannot overstate how thrilled I am to see Aussie businesses celebrated for their successes. Thank you to all the sponsors, the program partners, for making the 59th Australian Export Awards come to life. Stay tuned. Next year, a big milestone anniversary. It's going to be special. Good night. Thanks for having me.